Welcome to the Cross Canada Spotlight. I'm Mike Arsenault. Every week we take a look at a handful of the most interesting and entertaining stories produced across the Global News Network. First up on this first weekend of December, a coach gives an inspiring pep talk to a hockey team. Seems pretty basic, right? Well, the coach in question is 6 years old, and he's pumping up a collection of his hockey heroes.
We want that puck. That's our puck. So we got a skate coat, wool coat.
This is the speech that made it all happen. After hearing about the Pete's Next Generation game, where the OHL club signs kids to a single-day contract, Callan Perks saw his chance to become coach for a day.
And I'm like, in my head, I want to win so badly. So I tried to think of the best speech.
The six-year-old Peterborough Pete's fan says he wrote a speech, practiced a few times, then sent in his video.
So let's show it on ice. Let's go, boys!
And I was just totally overwhelmed by this kid's like enthusiasm and vibrancy, and I just knew that he was special.
So Callan became Coach Cal for the day. And when it was time to deliver his pregame speech to the Pete's, the grade 2 student admits he was nervous.
But then when I was in the room, I was just so excited to be giving a speech to the boys like Jerry Avon, Joe Carroll, Emmett Sproul, and Mason McTavish. It was just like so exciting.
Coach Cal dressed the part, sporting a suit and tie, and addressed the team.
Hi, this is my speech for tonight. Here we go. Legends are made every day, and you could be one of the greats. You are the chosen one. You are the years in the making.
Little did Coach Cal know his pep talk would explode, racking up more than 55,000 views online in just a few days. He's now being interviewed by media across Canada and the United States.
It's a good news story, and everyone's looking for a good feel-good story. So, I mean, everyone that's watching, you can't help but smile.
The Petes have joined the hype, creating Coach Cal t-shirts with proceeds going to the Canadian Cancer Society. As for Callan, his day with the Petes may be over, but his career in hockey is far from it.
Because I'm going to be an NHL player until I'm basically 45, and then I might be a coach or GM.
Megan Roy, Global News.
Cal definitely has the coach speech pattern and mannerisms down pat, and his passion really is infectious. I may need Cal to talk to me before my tennis matches. I was ready to run through a brick wall for him. And at only 6 years old, he potentially has a very long coaching career ahead of him. To BC for our next story, where research on sea lions' ability to hold their breath underwater for up to 16 minutes, yes, you heard me correctly, 16 minutes, and whether there could be implications for humans.
Meet Sitka, a 24-year-old, 400-pound Steller sea lion who's lived most of her life in the Vancouver Aquarium. And beyond delighting and helping to educate visitors, can now add a new credit to her resume, subject in some groundbreaking science.
Marine mammals have always fascinated me by their ability to hold their breath while they're underwater.
If you've ever tried it, you know how hard it is for a mammal to hold its breath underwater. Steller's sea lions can go for as long as 16 minutes without getting a breath. UBC marine mammal researcher Rhea Storland wanted to better understand how they do it.
What I was really interested in is how do their hearts help them to do that? And that's something that we just didn't have the answers to.
So with help from the staff at the Vancouver Aquarium and 8 female sea lions there, the males were just too big and too unruly, Storland was able to take heart monitoring equipment normally used on people and start collecting data about sea lion hearts.
This work would be very difficult to accomplish in the wild.
While they were under an anesthetic, Storland was able to collect ECG and ultrasound data about their heart function. The work was so interesting that some human heart doctors even came down to check it out. After 3 years, Storland was able to add some important new findings to science.
Marine mammals, yes, their heart works the same way, their heartbeat works the same way as a human's. However, the timing is a little bit different, and that's something that we didn't know before.
Storland's work has now been published in 2 scientific journals this year. In the future, she hopes to use attachable sensors, kind of like a sea lion Fitbit, to gather more data about them as they're swimming. For Sitka, the world of science thanks you for helping to advance human knowledge.
Stay back, Sitka.
In Vancouver, Paul Johnson, Global News.
Some very interesting findings there. And because I am so competitive, every time I'm in a pool, I'll challenge anyone who I'm with to an underwater breath-holding competition. I think my all-time best is 1 minute and 15 seconds. Apparently, I can learn a thing or two from the sea lions. To Alberta now, where a cat shows us the importance of rescuing animals when looking for some pet companionship for your family.
Amateur photographer Cassie Weiss and her favorite subject.
She doesn't know she's a supermodel.
And now one of their shots is making a big splash.
Smaller, is this your calendar?
On the cover.
Is that you?
Of Pet Values 2022 calendar.
We wanted to go out and take photos of her in the mountains and put her on top of the car, and the photo was taken.
This Calgary cat chosen out of more than 30,000 entries from all over Canada.
I didn't expect to even win. I was just like, oh, this is fun. So honestly, when I got the call, it was amazing.
What a change from that day 11 years ago when Cassie found Molly, a kitten, abandoned in the bush near a ball diamond.
And she was skin and bones. You could see her ribs. She was missing whiskers. She had a little chunk out of her ear.
Animals have always been close to Cassie's heart.
I love horses. I grew up on a ranch. Ideally, like, one of my goals is to end up, like, to buy some land and to train and rehabilitate horses.
All proceeds from calendar sales go to support rescue groups across the country. Many customers eager to help out.
Molly, this is Sophie, also a rescue. And I do a lot of rescue work. And so how nice that you do something to support this great cause. So I'm going to get one of your calendars. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
It really represents Canada. I mean, it's in the mountains, and the Rockies are such a prominent part of Canada. And I mean, I'm biased, but she is gorgeous.
Hi.
Gil Tucker, Global News.
It's awesome that all the proceeds from the calendar will go to help pets in need. We adopted our dog Cookie almost 3 years ago, and it was the best decision we ever made. I can't imagine our lives without her. Although it is taking longer than I thought for Cookie to be best friends with my 14-month-old daughter. I mentioned that we're now in the month of December and the big guy at the North Pole needs some help, but there seems to be a shortage of helpers available this year.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane.
It seems like everyone wants a visit from Old Saint Nick this Christmas. His calendar is normally booked from mid-November to Christmas Eve, but he's been so busy lately, Santa has been pulling double duty.
Sometimes twice a day. There's a lot of times where I'm multiple hours at one event. And in fact, next week, I believe, I have a Zoom. It's a four-hour Zoom. With various families from back east through a union.
There is a shortage of Santa helpers this year. At Hire a Santa, the North Pole operations manager has had to cancel almost 300 bookings. The reason? Mostly COVID-related with an unvaccinated younger age group.
Most of our Santas are in the older age group, right? And I've had people tell me that they don't want to work this year because they want to be able to visit with their grandkids. I've had Santa who's had, you know, they were on wait lists for like knee surgery and it's come through.
The tech-savvy Santas were a huge help last year with Zoom, and it continues to be in demand.
And in fact, tomorrow I have a Zoom event with a child from the UK. It's the first time I've done an international Santa event. It tells me that there is a definite shortage of Santa helpers.
Spreading good cheer is tops on Santa's list this holiday season.
We've been through a lot this year. We're still going through COVID. We had the wildfires in the summertime. Now we have the floods in the valley. I think people just want a break and they want something positive to look back on or to look forward to. And I think with the children, especially you see it in their eyes, the love and sometimes fear of Santa. It just brings joy, peace to so many, to parents and children alike.
Grace Key, Global News.
Before watching that story, I figured the pandemic would be an obvious culprit for the Santa shortage, but I didn't fully realize the myriad ways the men working as Santa helpers would be impacted. Hopefully, this is the last Christmas season we have such issues. And of course, it is the holiday season and not the golf season, but many golfers are flocking to indoor golf simulators to work on their games during the off season, including me, and I've been trying out some new training tools to try to get better as well. While the outdoor golf season may have ended in Ontario, that hasn't stopped me from trying to improve my game indoors on a simulator. My distance and accuracy are still improving, but I'm always looking for ways to get more consistency with my swing. That led me to a training aid called the True Turn Pro.
It helps with golf-specific joint function, patented as the first thoracic spine isolation rotation device. Whether someone is working in a preventative sense, in a rehabilitative sense, or a strength and conditioning sense, or a combination of all three, the device will ultimately get people more functional to then ultimately play more golf, seek more instruction, and better their games from being able to use their body more efficiently.
I've used the device 10 minutes a day for the past few weeks, and I do feel that my upper body rotation has improved, leading to more consistent contact. But would it be helpful to someone who hasn't taken lessons before and doesn't really understand the golf swing?
We don't want to be a swing aid. This is a device that we ultimately want to enhance the consumer's game, enhance the PGA professional's ability to teach, but not one that will ever be intended to replace that person.
The majority of the exercises with the True Turn Pro give a great stretch, and the dynamic exercises help create more speed and power. But the side bend stretch didn't make my back feel good. In fact, I stopped doing that stretch after only two sessions.
Don't do anything that is incredibly painful by any means. Monitor your progression through the exercises. If something is off or feeling off, then don't push it more than you should.
Obviously, my golf training knowledge is still limited, so I took the True Turn Pro to Modern Golf and my coach, Stu Bannatyne, to see what he thinks.
The golf swing isn't just a turn or just a tilt. We have to do both very well. And obviously working on a horizontal turn is great to turn our shoulders, but once we get in our golf posture, that makes sure that we tilt appropriately as well. One of the things you've struggled with in your golf swing is sometimes a little too much tilt and not enough turn. It's really helping you make sure you're making that big, wide turn. It's gonna improve your consistency. Probably add some distance too, which I think we've been seeing in your golf swing these days.
Now, could you do the same, get the same benefits by just using a regular golf club and going through the same exercises?
I think some of them, but I don't think everything. I think having the ability to match this to your arm length is very important. I love the fact, as I mentioned to you, that you could pull with your right hand and really feel that stretch coming in and really make that big turn. So I think having your arms extended, I think having something to keep you nice and wide away from your chest, I think that's really just opening up full rotation for the body.
Will my work with the True Turn and my work here at Modern Golf throughout the winter single digit handicap potentially for season 2022?
I think it's there. I think we still got to work on your putting a little bit, but you're hitting it long, you're hitting it straight, and that's going to be a really key part of getting you into the 70s one of these days soon too.
Mike Arsenault, Global News. Here's hoping all of my hard work during the winter can get me that single digit handicap in 2022. Or maybe I should ask one of Santa's helpers for some assistance. That's it for the Cross Canada Spotlight this week. Be sure to watch Global News Weekend Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7 a.m. on the Global TV app and Amazon Prime Video.